Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about writing decimals as fractions and fractions as decimals in this video. And the examples in my lectures are listed here in these boxes, so if you want to see if what you're looking for is in here. I'm going to be rounding everything to hundreds when necessary. If you think of fractions as having a power of 10 in the denominator, then each decimal place represents 1 0 in that denominator. Powers of 10 are 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, 1 million, etc. Once we have written the fraction, we reduce if possible. And if you're given a repeating decimal number, you should rewrite it before converting. In my first example, I have 0.75. Since there are two decimal places, we should have 2 zeros or 100 in the denominator. Always before I uncover the work, you could try it on your own to see if you're getting it right. I have 75 over 100. If I divide the top and the bottom by 25 to reduce it to lowest terms, that would be 3/4. The second one, 3 and 46 hundredths. 3 is a whole number and will not change as we move between decimals and fractions. Since there are two decimal places, we should have 2 zeros or 100 in the denominator again. 3 and 46 hundredths reduces to 3 and 23/50 when you divide both the top and the bottom by 2. Example number 3, 0 and 917 thousandths. There are 3 decimal places, which means 3 zeros or 1,000 in the denominator. This one does not reduce. There's no common factors between the numerator and denominator, so 917 over 1,000 is in lowest terms. But I want to talk about something for a second. 917 thousandths is how I would say it as a decimal, but I could also read it the exact same way, 917 thousandths as a fraction. When we say those things, we don't know which is which. Well, we're talking about fractions or decimals unless we're looking at it. They're pronounced in described in exactly the same way. All right, number 4, 7.444444. That's what a repeating bar over that number means. It repeats forever. To change it to a fraction, we need to rewrite it. Rounding to the hundredths place, we have 7.44. Now remember, the third number out would also be a 4. That's why the second number doesn't go up to 5, because it's followed by a 4. We would round that to 4. Now in our new number, 7.44, we have 2 decimal places, which again leads us to 2 zeros, and reducing by dividing the top and the bottom by 4 gives us 7 11/25. In number 5, we have 6 4/1000ths. That's 3 decimal places, so 3 zeros, and the 6 is still going to be 6. It doesn't matter whether it's followed by a decimal or a fraction. 4 over 1,000 reduces to 1 over 250. 18.3, there's 1 decimal place, so 1 0 or 10 in the denominator. The 18 is still going to be 18. We have 18 3/10. Notice that I read that the same whether it's a fraction or a decimal. In the second half, I'm looking at rewriting fractions into decimals, and to do that, you just divide the numerator by the denominator and round according to the given directions. Our directions are to round to the hundredth, so that's what I'm going to be doing. The whole number part will not change, and for me, I would just recommend you use your calculator to do that division. But 16 divided by 3 is 5.3333. I could go forever, that because I have a repeating number here, 3. Rounding that to the hundredths, you can see the third number out would be 3. Rounding back to that second place, I would still have a 3, so 5 33/100. In 10 1/4, remember the 10 does not change, and so we're just going to say that it's 10. It's 1/4 is 0.25, 1 divided by 4. That you might know because whenever you're talking about fourths, you should be able to do it in your head if you think of them as quarters. 1/4 is 25 cents or 0.25. So 10 1/4 is going to be 10.25. 4/5, 4 divided by 5 is 0.8. I don't need to round. That's all I have to do. And a side note about fifths is those kind of work out nicely. 1/5 is 0.2, 2/5 is 0.4, 3/5 is 0.6, And 4/5, that should be a 5. 4/5 is 0.8, so those are kind of nice, easy ones to know. 4 2/3, remember the 4 does not change. If I divide 2 by 3, though, we get 0.66666. And we're asked to round to the hundredth, so what should I get as a final answer? Well, the third place out is a 6. Rounding back to the second place should give me a 7. So my final answer is 4.67, or 4 67/100. Remember, the 4 doesn't change. And we also have to really think about the third number if we're rounding back to that second place. 7/9 also is a repeating number. 7/9 is 0.7 repeated. What does that look like rounded to two places? Well, it'd be 0.77777. Rounding from a 7 backwards makes that go up to 0.78. And a little side note about the ninths, 1/9 is 0.1 repeating, 2/9 is 0.2 repeating, 3/9 is 0.3 repeating, and so on. But we always have to round carefully. We can't just say it's 0.33, 0.55, 0.77. We have to think about it. This would be 0.33, but obviously the 0.777 would be 0.78. So round carefully. And 8 3/8, the 8 will not change. We're going to divide the 3 by 8 and get 0.375, but we have to round that to the hundredths, which gives us 8.38. I did go through this pretty quickly, but the process should not be that difficult for you, and I hope you have a fantastic day.